in the name of God, merciful and almighty. I'm very happy that once again have an opportunity to lay down the views of Islamic Republic of Iran in line with the challenges in the field of international security. I would like to thank General of the Army Shoigu for invitations and chairmanships at this meeting. Since the last conference, I warned about the increasing of the military of Tahrir and terrorist groupings in the Western Asia and expansion their activities to the Caucasus, Central Asia, western part of China and India and Europe. Today's terrorism concentrated to destroy the stability and escalation of crisis and preparation of conditions of internal and external challenges in such countries as Syria, Iraq, and Afghanistan, and Libya, and Yemen, the states of Northern Africa, and also some of the European countries became the arena for their inhuman and anti mankind crimes. And of course, it's a pity that some of the states at regional and international levels, they provide multilateral support in terms of education in military and ideological aspects, esteemed participants. The question is rising, what are the main factors influencing the dissemination and practical activity of extremist organizations, and one of the factors are the political conditions, misery and poverty, economic dependence, and the presence of hegemonic system influencing the destinies of the nations under the dictatorship of these regimes. And isn't it the reason for developing the ethnical and religious contradictions and very serious clashes between these groups? It's the ground for intervention into the internal affairs of these countries, as it, and also serves as a justifications for interventions. And isn't it the reason the use by the United States double and even multiple standards to these issues concerning the infringement of stability and security with the use of wars and increase of state expenses for the military purposes? Maybe it's also the ground to repeat the situation to create conditions for to unleash one more global war. Ladies and gentlemen, realistic understanding of the situation and actual response to these issues could bring us to the road to find effective strategies and ways to settle these problems. We are convinced that today the whole of the world is under condition that there is no security, that is instability to disseminate this horror which was caused by these Tahririst and Zionist tendencies and supported by Saudi Arabia. And there are certain sponsors and creators of terrorist groupings, and they do not want to continue this struggle to the end to gain victory over terrorism, but they cover their actual intentions by humanitarian slogans about the ceasefire, about the political rallies, and they would simply would like to create conditions to create those forces which were already destroyed and suffered losses. Islamic Republic of Iran, they have studied the extremists Those groups, from the very first day of their existence, they warned about the tragedy which the nations may come across. And it was necessary to defend by all its means to protect those Tafarist and Zionist organizations, and today we bear the last, the most serious expenses. And the Eastern Asian regions, where America is continuing to have its own interests and as part of their doctrine, and to provide their own hegemony, they try to establish very broad military presence and create a coalition in order to resist to the efforts of regional powers, especially on the Korean Peninsula and the Chinese Sea, where the formation of coalition and signing of security treaty, they make the problems of this region ever more complicated and dangerous. Esteemed participants, the defense policy of Islamic Republic of Iran to counter destabilization, which comes from Tafarist terrorism, is based on the creation of security, and our defense policy is to actively retain and constrain the terrorist actions, power and logic, and these are the fundamental principles of Islamic Republic of Iran. We have developed the indigenous military potential, and also based on cooperation with the friendly countries, and we will continue to enhance our programs. And the logic of Iran to resist to these destabilizing factors, we will act in a very tough manner, in line with the international laws, to ensure peace, stability, and we'll rely also on maximum possible cooperation. And in line with this policy, we rely on the following. Islamic Republic of Iran never did before and will not make any threats to national security of other countries, and condemns any aggression and use of force against the sovereignty and freedom of neighboring states. Islamic Republic of Iran, being in the advance guard to the factors which offer strength, threat, will rely on the requirements of the demands of the nation, on the needs of the Yemen's and Syrian people to ensure their political independence and stability. The decisive struggle against terrorism and with terrorist movements wouldn't be possible if there is no true decisiveness and will without cooperation with all responsible states and international structures to destroy international terrorist organizations, not to provide financial support, and not to create safe conditions for their presence in different regions. One of the symbol of this cooperation is the presence of Russia in Syria, which led to the superiority of the Syrian land forces, and raised the ability of Syrian army and Syrian people to fight against terrorism, and which is very promising strategy to give and bring back peace and stability so that Syrian people could solve their problems without foreign interference. Islamic Republic of Iran, basing on Islamic tuition, supports all liberation movements which contribute to the national identity and sovereignty, together with their nations who are trying to resist to the policy of hegemonism. The Lebanon Hezbollah, al-Shabi in Iraq are such movements which will always be having support from Islamic Republic of Iran, independent governments, and Islamic world all over the planet. Islamic Republic of Iran believes that production and accumulation of the mass destruction weapons and nuclear weapons runs counter to the interests of the world, and also insists on disarmament of the false Zionist regime, which also causes threat to the security and safety of the region. We support the movement to free the world from nuclear weapons. Cyber threat is also requiring our attention, because cyberspace is a very important issue and should be part of the agenda of every session on security issues, and we are prepared to cooperate with other countries which are interested to resist those threats. Islamic Republic of Iran, having tremendous human resources and having researchers and scientists and tremendous industrial infrastructure and defense industry to support their goals and national interests, would attempt steps at the highest level possible to ensure military potential of our country, and no other will prevent us from developing our capabilities, including missile capabilities of Iran. I would like to extend once again thanks to Defense Minister of Russia and his colleagues for offering us the chairmanship at this conference. Thank you for your attention.